Hello, this is L. Wilter here with another playthrough. In my last playthrough, my character ended out of my error. I accidentally selected a new game, and that is what we're about to do here. We're going to start a new adventurer, and this new adventurer is going to be a born-again justice, which is a criminal, and in my case, it will be a murderer who is put into prison in France. And then let go in the new world. But instead of being born again or reformed, they're actually the same person they were when they were put in the prisons. And so they will be killing, murdering, and scalping everyone they see. Be interesting about how to deal with depression. I'll see if criminals have that much empathy. So first we'll start a new gang. We're gonna go to the Born Again Justice, which the game says is lacking colonists to populate the new world. France empties its persons and sends these volunteers to New France. Having been in prison, these men are the perfect choice to populate this hostile new land. So it's not by choice that But Born Again Justice. We're just gonna see what they're good at. Look like they're okay with dodging. They're stealth. They're cooking. But everything else seems a bit poor. You know, their senses. Maybe a little bit on fighting, not much. They're French, of course. Thinking about what skills I would like to increase. You know, I think I don't want to increase the easy to raise skills. And so I'm not going to use knowledge. These are fairly easy to raise in the game. Maybe an issue early on with these survival skills, fishing, herbalism, and survival. Looking at the senses, and that's what I'm thinking about. I'm going to try to raise all the skills above 46. Raise that one, and this should be the last one. Or 40. Alright, we're going to start this summer. And where should we start? Montreal is a bit bugged. Let's start in English territory. This will increase. And let's start with your normal character. Here's our character. Here's our equipment. Ah, very fitting. A woodsman knife. It's a great starting weapon, actually. So seeing that we're starting out, we're just going to find some cutting stones. See if we get lucky and maybe find a gem or pyrite and selects, which is checking is flint. Selects, that's good. Change my voice settings. I think I have push to talk on, and I'm actually going to turn that off. Okay, back. So, I mean, I know we're going to be murdering people, but let's shoot out a prayer. Didn't hear a crow. I actually saw a crow. to it. It seems a bit slower than the Xbox game. I think. Let's see how it goes. We're in the Southern Territory, so we're south of the river. It's my first is to head up north. Yeah. Or, you know what, let's go ahead down south. No one ever goes down south. Oh, my last playthrough, when I was in the Quebec area, were Spanish Dubons. That may have been Dutch or German Baylor, I'm not sure. Bergen Thaler or something like that. But we'll see what there is here. Right now we're just looking for some water. Preferably a big pool of water where we're good fish. One of my goals was to reach Florida in the game, I mean, which is, you know, highly unrealistic. I don't know, maybe not possible yet. Here we found a lake, so that will provide us with a fishing spot, but we won't be able to catch any frogs here. And see if there's anyone around. You know, I think there is a bit of accuracy in Last Winter where there tends to be more people. So my last playthrough is heavy into mapping out, trying to find the tomb. On this one, I'm not going to do any mapping. There you go, this is the perfect spot. We have some water where we can catch frogs and fish against the lake. We can search along the beach. And now the question is, are they Iroquois or Huron? Huron, oh nice, they're happy, yes. So, let's start catching some frogs. This will increase our survival. Also, a good reason to start out with eating frogs, especially if your survival skills not well. If I can piss off the Huron in their lodges. I think I've tried that and it doesn't. I think you can do it, but it's very difficult because I've tried to do it with houses as well. And somehow there's a trick to it, but I forget what the trick is. Or maybe not. Them or piss them off, they'll kind of charge out of the house, but then sometimes they won't. No frogs, that's okay. We've increased our survival skill by 25%. It's about to be higher. Yeah, once you get to about 25, 30, you're fairly comfortable on survival. That would be great. Next is to get some pyrite. Make a fire without having to rely on fire skill. native lodges, don't have many goods. So, they're not the best trading places. But, you know, sometimes you get lucky. I was thinking, maybe if I gather items, I can maybe trade for something here. Maybe they'll have more native items. Board, water board. Let's see about this. There's a first draw. We're still going to get some frogs. Two. I don't know when. Anyway, we'll just keep on getting frogs. Well, at least 5 frogs. Now, you can't eat frogs raw, and I don't believe I've gotten worms from them. But don't take my word on it. I think frogs are... more frogs and we'll double the survival skill of our starting character. So, it's not that bad if you start a low survival skill. Just find a place to get some frogs. Especially the lower it is, the faster it will ride. Even when I've played as long as, like, until winter, you know, it's really easy to stay in a spot like this, but it gets harder if you just start wandering, you know.
So let's say, theoretically, you were here for a month.
You know, you just hung around here. Survival kicks in fairly quickly because then you gotta find out where to hunt, find your food. You know, you don't know where it is because you have to find it unless you go back to your campsite. So, even for a long term person in this game, it's still a bit difficult to survive. My frog, as I said, was good, but I'm gonna try to bring it up to 30 before I. So, you know, lakes won't always have a house like this, but I do think having, well, at least what I call a lake, a large body of water, it does attract whether it's wanderers or settlements. I think it's always good to walk around an area. I've never built corners, so that's why there's no water. Maybe that'll be a thing and then and continue on our way. If you're new to the game, I would settle down a bit. This survival's not my greatest priority. I want to see if there's something like. What is that? Right there. Oh, it did well right there. Ah, there we go. Quite a quick animal. If I'm being a fool. Ah, yeah. Missed it. Okay, I would have lost the deer, but apparently not. No, but we'll lose the deer. Lots of rocks, a little bit of water. Do another recording of this. The recording device I have right now is rocks. Seeming precious stone. There's a little bit of wealth, right? Right. I'll pick up some branches off the ground. Fire, maybe not too far from the water. Then we're going to light the fire. It increases our survival. Here we are. First night, we have a fire set up. We have some food cooking. First European we murder. I'm gonna say European because the native sometimes don't provide much. We'll be off pretty well. You'll probably have a gun once we do that. But not everyone. Roll frog legs. Herb, or what do you say, my baby? Herbalism. Herb.
Herb.
Not his, not a his herbalism.
Is, or you say is?
Yeah, not a herbalism, but a herbalism. Herb. Baby, we can't dump stones in the fire. Hey,
I'm
two precious stones now. Alright. Fire. I want to start. Battling with hunger. Initially, catching frogs or catching your fish will take a fair bit of your day, you know. And you'll maybe work a third of the day to play it the rest of the day, or a quarter of the day, maybe not a whole third of the day. Herbalism. Isn't that pretty clean? Oh, there's one more flower up there for me. Or more plant, rather, not flower. See if this is far enough to the fire yet.
rocks, some stone. Might get gold, unlikely, but. Get something to drink. I'm gonna take a little
nap. You don't need to.
Stone.
That's why I like to play it daytime, so I can see more.
And we're off. Never to return, probably.
Objective is murder, so I'm not focusing too much down, getting comfortable line. There, so I don't need to get it much.
There's a stone circle in the corner. Let's see if I can get anything from there. Wooden spoon. Oh, let's steal it. Blueberry spoon. Yes, I can. Cool. That's what I'm gonna beat people up with. Gonna beat them with a spoon.
Found a stone circle.
roll does strike, loop strike an animal that has a chance of lying there. Maybe it could be injured. So maybe it won't run too quickly. First of all, we're going to sweep the stun down. Basically, what gets the animals out is observing it. Like a little pebble falling sound. Wolf action looks like it looks fairly large. That's odd. A message is coming up. 6 meters. That's a bit steep. But you know what? Now for fun, I am going to do a spin. Looks like he's despawned, but he could have, but he could still be on this screen. Alright, he's not here. We're gonna go look. Oh, look at that. Hey, Skunky. A raccoon, whatever. This would be a great way to build up my meaty skills at least. Let's just get ahead of him. I had a raccoon attack me before. You know what our first kill could? Trusty wooden spin. Could a raccoon. That word, it rhymes. Could a raccoon with a spoon. Let's take it.
Antioxidants,
okay, cool. Awesome. We're going to eat our antioxidant blueberries. Okay. We're going to go after that wolf. But we're going to drink some water before. You didn't want me to.
I'm going to get everything now. I'm going to come back to the screen. That isn't fat. That might be good for like a starvation. And.
And if we get a tendon, we can maybe make some obsidian knives. Else. Check, how long has this been recording? 36 minutes. Okay, I'm gonna stop right here and start a new episode. Alright,